the work.
Last year, published by Social Science Quarterly, that the estimated amount of reparations owed to African people in the U.S. is $14.2 trillion. White people owe reparations, but not only for the enslavement of Africans, we owe reparations for the ongoing colonization of Africans in the United States. And Yes Magazine published this really good story last year called 40 Acres and a Mule Would Be at Least $6.4 trillion today, in addition to $14.2 trillion for slavery. And hopefully you'll have a chance to look at this graphic. It has a lot of really good statistics in it. But I want to talk about a few things in it. Now, it seems to me it's not enough for whites to say we agree with or support reparations. We could leave today and say, yeah, this sounds good, let's put some pressure on the government to pay. What are we doing to change the material relationship that we have to oppressed Africans in the United States? How are we acting today in material and measurable ways? So when we pay reparations right now, this goes to the struggle of African people for power so that they can get that $14.2 trillion check, but also so that they can build a dual continuum of power, so that they can have programs that benefit African people who have been prevented by the existing system from gaining access to the resources that are necessary for life. So how is this connected? Because I'm talking about Africa and I'm talking about the United States. And according to African internationalism, the colonial oppression of Africans in Africa, in the United States, and all Africans throughout the African diaspora is connected. White people in the U.S. are European colonizers on stolen indigenous land, and the entire European nation and white identity lives off the stolen labor and resources of colonized Africans and all other oppressed peoples of the world, who are the majority of humanity. White people are actually the minority, as well as other animals and the planet itself. It's also an environmental issue. All white people sit on the pedestal of the oppression of African people. All white people have benefited from the accumulated value of the slave trade. All white people benefited from the European colonization of Africa. We all benefited from the European genocide against the indigenous people of the Americas and the theft of their land. All white people have a different relationship to the police than the black community. And all white people have a responsibility to end our complicity with this social system that murders and oppresses in our name. All white people have a responsibility to stand in solidarity with African liberation. Now, this is not white guilt. The call for reparations is based on material understanding of history. It's a scientific analysis of why Europe and white people have wealth and power. And it's on account of this dialectical parasitic relationship with Africa and all African people and all other nations colonized by white power. By parasitic, once again, we're talking about the dialectic of there's the host and there's the parasite. The parasite lives off of the host to the detriment of the host. The host becomes sick, becomes weak, and is unable to live because of the parasite. This has been the relationship that has been imposed on Africa and the world since the 15th century. So the call for reparations from white people is based on this theory of African internationalism.